Hello, this is Johan from the South African sysadmin in Russia, and today we're going to look at Skype for Linux. Is it important? Is it worth installing? Is it worth using? Is it safe? No, it's not so encrypted as Wired and other apps, but it is important. I think it is one of the most important things of 2017. For Linux. And I know this is a bit weird to say, and I'm sure many people will disagree with me, but this is the reasons. As a sysadmin at the university, one of the main reasons why we are able to run Linux on all the computers and not Windows is simply because we can run all the apps which people expect to have on a computer, and that includes Skype. If Skype isn't there, there's no way anybody here would be willing to run Ubuntu, because they all want Skype. They all want Microsoft apps like Microsoft Office, because everybody is stuck still to this. And it's not a bad thing. It's decent apps, and with programs like Crossover and Skype versions, which is now up to standard with the rest of the world, that is what Skype for Linux is. It looks like the same like your Windows apps, your Android apps, your Mac apps. So they have really picked it up to the level. It's not just an app which they have to have, but it's something that is really nice and worthy. Because Skype, like for me, like my parents, they use Skype. And we live in a different country because I'm in Russia and they are in South Africa. Because they use Skype, I can communicate with them, and I need Skype on my computer. As I am using Ubuntu on a daily basis, that means that if there wasn't a Skype client for Linux, I would not have been able to, I would have had to at least have a Windows PC somewhere to Skype with my parents. So, in this case, Skype is so important, and if Skype wasn't there, what would have been there? Yeah, so that's why I think Skype for Linux is a huge thing. Yesterday, on the 1st of March, Skype for Linux Beta was released. I think about a year ago, Skype for Linux Alpha was released, and during the year we saw about 17 versions of Skype for Alpha and saw the way they improved. I made the videos about it on my other channel, which I just use for like background music, which I started off with, and then this year I started with this new channel of mine, Your Friendly Penguin, with voiceovers, but I keep them both running. I love them both. This is one of my new channels. I hope it grows quickly. But yeah, so basically, if you want to see the road of Skype for Linux Alpha, you can go to my other channel, Ubuntu Made Simple, and check it out. But I think that a Skype for Beta is not anymore a Skype for Skype, just like a little app somewhere which you can go and test. That it's the only one they give you to download on the Skype site. So it means they really trust in it. They really see it is the main Skype version, so I can't imagine that it will be Skype for Beta for a long time. I'm sure in the next month or two or three or four, we all gonna have Skype for Linux and no longer Beta, because it's really up to standard with great bots, with great user phone calling. Well, I tried this to a Skype for Linux Alpha call to my parents last weekend. The sound was fine, but the picture on my side was frozen. They were fine. So basically, it's not perfect yet, but it's getting there. And with Skype for Beta, I will try it again this Saturday, and hopefully I'll be able to do a little vlog next week about Skype and my thoughts on it, or just a quick run through. If there's time, if there's not other awesome things happening in the world of Linux and in my life. And thank you for watching. See you tomorrow, and goodbye.